Registration in the narthex. Also, just a reminder that next week is Pentecost Sunday, so we will try to wear red to service and also to bring a red candle with you to service. Any candle, just red. A couple of prayers and thank yous for this past week. Caitlin, one of our youth, had ankle surgery on Tuesday, and the surgery went very well, so we are grateful for that, and we just want to keep her in our prayers while she recovers and goes through therapy and gets back to 100%. Also, yesterday the church celebrated the life of Mary Lee Waller, and I want to thank the deacons and church members who prepared and served the lunch yesterday. We are asking if anyone's available to break down the tables after service today. The tables and chairs are still set up down in Fellowship Hall. And one correction in the bulletin we just need to note. Under the church families that we are praying for this week, we do want to add Zach Mitchum. I believe it just says Sarah. But we are praying for both Zach and Sarah Mitchum, along with Laura Mersnick and her children, Tyler and Samantha Joe, and Bruce and Vicki Mitchell. So we want to remember them this week. And now, let us invite the Spirit of God and prepare our hearts for worship.
Your presence. Amen.
Let us gather as God's children, joyful that God is here. Please stand as we lift up our voices in our call to worship. A word of encouragement came from prophet to people.
Live a life that is full. Build, plant, eat, love, multiply.
Pray for your communities.
Be God in the center of all that is.
We enter into worship today with hope in our hearts.
For something happens here that reminds us that we can live as God desires.
God has made a promise of faithfulness to us.
And we can trust the promise.
Will you please sing along with us?
King of all days, oh so highly exalted.
Do not be afraid. Whatever you fear, God has a plan for your life. Whatever you have done, God is ready to forgive you. Even now, God makes a way for us to be made whole. Let us pray to the one who loves us and offers a new way to live. Let us pray.
We want you to know, Holy God, that we do try. We hear the Bible say that you have a plan for us, but it is still so easy to become confused as to how we should live. We spend so much time trying to win the approval of our friends and our family that we forget we are supposed to help others in need. We are so busy making the plans for our own lives, we often ignore the plans you have for us. God, we do not come to you expecting an easy way out, because we know what it costs you to forgive us. But we believe in your love, and so we say we are sorry and ask you to make us whole. In our silence, give us faith to trust in your plan.
God's plan for me is to be loved by Him and to believe the good news of what Jesus has done for me. God's plan for all of us to be freed of our past and to be healed by Christ's gentle touch. Friends, believe God's plan. We are loved and forgiven. Let us share God's love and forgiveness by the sign of peace. The peace of Christ be with you all.
And also
with you.
God, we give you thanks that you love us and have a plan for our lives. God of love, help us to feel you in our hearts and minds, to know that you carry us even as we stumble. When we cannot think for ourselves, guide us. When we do not know what we are feeling, care for us. When we do not know what to do next, show us the way. Today, we pray we can begin to live out your plans by having openness of hands. Through our lives, hands have been held open to each of us. Hands to wipe our tears, to pull us from the ground and offer a cup of cold water. Now we ask for help to extend our own to others. Empower us. Put your plan in action to meet our neighbor's needs. The need for food, clothing, shelter, and for grace. We now pray for others, especially our mothers and the women who have loved us and cared for us. We pray for our fathers and the men who have played with us and strengthened us. And now we pray for those who are sick, sad, or tired, and for those who have not had a good mom or dad. With open minds, we hear your plan to share your message of hope. With open hearts, we go to offer your plan to heal to others. With open hands, we go to offer your plan of forgiveness and love to others. And now we pray the Lord's Prayer in a new and simple way. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven.
Give us today our daily bread.
Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Let us prepare our hearts for God's word. Let us pray. Teaching God, give us open hearts, as open and eager as when we were children, listening to the stories our parents and teachers read to us. Give us open ears, that we may hear your plans for us in these words that instruct and challenge us. Amen. Our first Bible reading is a wisdom lesson from the book of Proverbs, chapter 3, verses 1 through 2, and verses 5 through 8. Listen to these instructions to trust and honor God. My child, do not forget my teachings, but let your heart keep my commandments. For length of days and years of life and abundant welfare they will give you. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and do not rely on your own insight. In all your word and all your ways acknowledge him, and he will make straight your path. Do not be wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and turn away from evil. It will be a healing for your flesh and a refreshment for your body. This is God's plan for us this and every day. Thanks be to God.
The youth have prepared a special message for our kiddos, so if the children would please come forward. They can sit in this front row of the pews up here.
Oh Lord, I just know you have something amazing and huge for me today. Speak to me, Lord, your faithful servant listens.
Hey dude, can you throw my ball back to me?
Speak to me, Lord, your faithful servant is listening.
Okay, can you please throw my ball back to me?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm a Christian. I was listening for God. Wow, those groceries look really heavy. Yep, they're really heavy. Speak to me, Lord.
Oh man, look at that beautiful sunset. You know what? For the first time in my life, I think I believe in God. I believe I can know him. Oh my, I wish someone could tell me how to know God.
Yep, that's a beautiful sunset. Speak to me, Lord.
Okay, maybe not.
Dirt, man.
Hey, dude.
Hey, Dirt. I don't know you very well, but you seem like someone I can talk to. My life is so screwed up. I need a change. I need a new start. I need God's peace in the world just like you. I need...
Rick, I don't mean to be rude, but I'm trying to listen to God, and I keep getting interrupted. I just need some peace and quiet. Maybe we can talk later?
Oh, sure. I'll talk to you later.
Alright, see ya. Please, God, talk to me. Your faithful servant is listening. What is your will for me today?
Thank you. found in the Old Testament from the prophet Jeremiah. Jeremiah chapter 29, verses 11 through verse 14. Listen to God's word for those who feel far away from God. For surely I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord, plans for your welfare and not for harm, to give you a future with hope. Then when you call upon me and come and pray to me, I will hear you. When you search for me, you will find me, if you seek me with all your heart. I will let you find me, says the Lord, and I will restore your fortunes and gather you from all the nations and all the places where I have driven you, says the Lord, and I will bring you back to the place from which I sent you in exile. Here ends God's promise for a future with hope. Amen.
Life is a journey. It's a journey through time from birth to death, from youth to maturity. Every person's journey is unique. My journey is currently 37 days short of half a century. Preparing this message has been a great experience for me because it required me to think about my entire life, God's presence in it, and God's plans for me. After much thought and reflection, I've come to the conclusion that my life has been a journey of detours and many blessings. I am a planner and an organizer. I like to know what is going to happen so I can do my best to prepare for it. I don't like the unknown because I can't plan for it. I've made countless plans during my life. Many of my plans have turned out the way I thought they would, but not all of them have. For instance, I envisioned I would be a youth group advisor, but I never dreamed it would last 11 years or that I would be giving a sermon on Youth Sunday. Life unfolds and alters my plans. Life forces me to take unexpected detours on my journey. Many of the detours in my life have been good ones. The best detour happened in 1984 in a classroom at the University of Illinois. When I started college, I was dating my high school sweetheart. I dated him for almost 4 years, and I thought I would marry him. However, the detour that started in that classroom in 1984 changed my course forever. I met Jerry Lyon in the math class on the very first day of college. We were friends for over 3 years before we started dating our senior year. My placement in that math class freshman year put me on the path of becoming Jerry's wife and Neil and Scott's mom. Jerry, Neil, and Scott are by far the greatest blessings in my life. They bring me much joy and happiness. I can't imagine my life without them, and I am incredibly thankful my path crossed with Jerry's path. When thinking about life's detours, it is very easy to acknowledge the blessings that come from the good detours. It's always easy to feel gratitude when things are going well. That's human nature. Being thankful during the hard times is a challenge, but I have learned that the difficult detours are the ones that have blessed and changed me the most. My parents' illnesses and deaths were the two most difficult detours in my life. My dad got sick when I was 16 years old, and he died when I was 28. He had a rare illness called Still's disease, and unfortunately, he was in constant pain for 12 years. Our lives were forever changed by his illness, and I learned many important lessons from my dad in this difficult detour. Dad never lost faith in spite of his constant pain. He never questioned God or asked, "Why me?" He hoped and prayed for healing, and he was never discouraged by his unanswered prayers. He accepted the situation gracefully. I was a teenager and young adult during this time. I hoped and prayed for him to be healed too, but I was discouraged, and I did question God. After years of watching my dad's unwavering faith, I began to pray differently. I started asking God to help me accept his will regarding my dad. For the first time in my life, I finally recognized and accepted that God's will is not always going to match my will. That was a very defining moment in my faith journey. I learned to let go of my plans and trust God's plans. My mom passed away 2 years ago from pancreatic cancer. Her illness was definitely a difficult detour in my life. I helped take care of her for 2.5 years, and she lived with us for 9 months while she was in hospice. Taking care of my mom was definitely an unexpected detour, but the caregiving was not difficult for me. It was a broken relationship with my brother that complicated the situation and turned my world upside down. This was by far the hardest and most stressful situation in my life, but it was also the most transformational time of my faith journey. I learned that I cannot control all circumstances or other people, but I can control how I react to them. I learned that peace is not the absence of conflict, but true peace comes from knowing Jesus. Difficult situations are bearable when I trust God to take care of me and remember that He will never forsake me or leave me. I have learned to appreciate the difficult detours in life because they bring me closer to God. If my journey had no obstacles for me to overcome, my faith would not be as developed as it is. In the first chapter of James, it says, "Consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance." Scripture tells us when our faith is tested, we are supposed to find joy in our trials. I always look for the silver lining in bad circumstances because that helps me seek God and discover His blessings. I still prefer to make plans and be organized, but I learned long ago that my plans won't always line up with God's plans. Thankfully, hindsight is 20/20, and I can look back on the past 50 years and see that God has been with me every step of the way. Because of that, I can say with confidence that God will be with me in the future, regardless of my plans. He knows the story of my life and how all the pieces fit together. God can see the big picture. I am putting the pieces together one day at a time. I honestly have no clue what my future holds, but that is fine with me, because God knows. Jeremiah 29:11 reminds me, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you a hope and a future." I'm going to take God at His word. No matter what my future holds, I will trust Him with all my heart and continue to discover my blessings.
Good morning.
Good morning.
It is a real joy to be in front of you this morning as one of our youth sponsors. Mary Kay, Ronnie, Tim, and now Melissa and Tim Gingrich and I have been a part of your kids' lives as we seek to cultivate their faith development. For the past 10 years, I've had the pleasure of watching your kids grow in faith and navigate the complications of their life plans and journeys. Our fellowship, Bible studies, off services, and mission trips have provided opportunities to question and be challenged in a spirit of nurture. Throughout the years, we have had awesome youth, and this year is no exception. We have appreciated the congregation's support and ask you to continue to pray for our youth and their spiritual journeys. We are hoping by such we will have more Melissa Lulie Gingriches returning to continue this important ministry of making young disciples. With that said, I want to begin this morning with sharing a story. When I was in grade school, my parents had a good friend, Lynn Eaton, come to visit. They hadn't seen Lynn in a few years, so they were eager to get caught up. As most conversations begin, questions about how's the family, how are the kids, and what's going on at work ensued. Like most kids, I lost interest and found myself distracted in my own world of play. And then I heard my name mentioned and my ears perked up. I don't know what prompted this conversation, but my dad started to tell Lynn how when we lived in Germany and my mom was pregnant with me, her pregnancy had not gone as expected. Apparently, mom had abnormal bleeding during her first trimester, and the doctors advised my parents to get an abortion. They speculated I would be deformed, mentally challenged, or in today's vernacular, special needs. Now, Ronnie has touted my praises on more than one occasion, letting you all know indeed how special I truly am. But not according to those German doctors' warnings. It was at that moment I experienced the powerful affirmation of belonging. My parents chose to keep me regardless of the potential imperfect outcome. From that story, my dad told me, God has a plan for your life. So this morning's scripture from Jeremiah 29 should be comforting, but in reality, it's often perplexing and sometimes annoying. If God knows the plans he has for me, why hasn't he shared them with me? Why have there been so many times of uncertainty and confusion about what direction I should travel? I remember questioning what college I should go to, what career path to follow, if I should serve as a VISTA worker or get a real paying job. I remember asking God if a pleasant young man asking me to marry him should be my husband. The answer was he was not. God had more adventurous plans for me with a man named Ronnie Osborne. Plans. Most of us like plans. That's why we have calendars and apps to keep us organized, with bells and dings to remind us where to be. Surprises and detours can be disruptive and frustrating. Detours challenge our sense of order and for some send us into anxiety attacks. Our need for decently and in order may start to unravel. When that happens, and it will, how do we maintain our sense of equilibrium in this journey of life? Gratefully, we have been given directions to search for God. Jeremiah 29:13 says, we will find God when we search for him with all our hearts. Our Proverbs passage tells us to trust God with all our hearts, and he will direct our path. At first glance, this would appear as a no-brainer. Let go, let God, and he'll show us the way. But this, friends, is the rub. It's hard to let go. We have been raised to be self-sufficient, disciplined, productive individuals. If we try hard enough, we can find our own way. If we try hard enough, good things will happen. Yet this doesn't always hold true. Those we love fall ill, that perfect job was given to someone else, those unforeseen expenses keep mounting. Our best friend betrays us and leaves us feeling rejected and insecure. We wonder, is this really God's plan for my life? Our journeys and paths take multiple twists and turns. Unexpected plans emerge and force us to stop and determine which way we go. A couple of years ago, Ronnie and I were heading to Kansas City to see his brother and sister. As we approached the city, he took a detour and exited a way I was unfamiliar. Naturally, I asked him, where are we going? With a sly grin, he said, trust me. Now, you all know Ronnie. That could mean anything. But as we checked into the Raphael on the plaza, I was thrilled. My anticipated good getaway turned into a delightful getaway. My plan was enhanced and became so much more. Trust me, he said, just like God tells you and I to trust him. The key and ultimate question then is, do you and I trust God to know his plan for our lives? Do you and I trust God for something good to the point where we can let go of control, worry, and fear? Do we trust God to see us through? Now, my favorite psalm is Psalm 139. The psalmist tells us, O Lord, you have examined my heart and know everything about me. You know when I sit down or stand up. You know my every thought went far. You chart the path ahead of me and tell me where to stop and rest. Every moment you know where I am. You know what I am going to say even before I say it. You proceed and follow me. You place your hand of blessing on my head. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me, too great for me to know. Verse 13 picks up and reads, You made all the delicate inner parts of my body and knit me together in my mother's womb. Thank you for making me so wonderfully complex. Your workmanship is marvelous, and how well I know it. You watched me as I was being formed in utter seclusion, as I was woven together in the dark womb. You saw me before I was born. Every day of my life was recorded in your book. Every moment was laid out before a single day had passed. Now, in light of my introduction, isn't that amazing? This truth, though poignant for me, is absolutely true for each of you as well. God knows the plans he has for you, plans for good and not for evil, to give you a future with hope. As a wife, mother, friend, and colleague, my heart's desire has always been to be an encourager, to point people to Christ when life is messy. Have you had unexpected plans emerge and forced you to stop and determine which way to go? We might not know the exact details or circumstances ahead of us, but be encouraged. God is watching. He cares about you and me, and his plans are indeed good. Amen.
Please stand and sing the next song with us.
You are amazing, God.
God's plan for us is to be his helpers, to give water for the thirsty, comfort to those who grieve, healing for ones in pain, friendship to those who are different and alone. And part of God's plan is to offer our time and strength, as well as money, that Christ's message and forgiveness may be shared with others. Will the ushers gather our gifts?
Comfort.
together and sing a new version of the doxology.
Father and the Son
and Holy Ghost,
as it was
in the beginning,
is now and ever shall be.
Thank you, gracious God, for making your home with us and claiming us as your children. We offer ourselves and our gifts toward your plan for the new world you are trying to make among us. However, peace emerges from respect and honest relationships. May we live by your plan to reflect your love in our attitudes and actions, when we are together and when we are apart. Amen.
It's gonna get loud in here.
Yeah, hey.
There are days of taking more than I
was blind and I'm not feeling, and I struggle to breathe.